Alright, and we are back. I apologize as well, because I'm pretty sure I was pretty much, dead tired for days 6 and 7, and kind of just goofing off during those as well, as I talked about. So, a bit fresher now. It's been, I don't know, 4 or 5 days since I last recorded, and I've been working on processing and uploading the videos. So hopefully, I don't bore you quite as much this time. And we are here at the start of week 2, and getting ready to continue forward. We held off the week 1 easily enough, as I recall. Helped along, you know, by the fact that we had a full concrete walls. We have, what, 3 forges going? Looks like tools and weapons are not nearly as good as I would like, but, you know, we'll go with it. We'll go with it, we'll keep improving. So, prime considerations for this week. We still want to up our level further. We want to max out Call of Joan scavenging, and hopefully during the latter half of the week, we really get cranking in terms of finding good stuff out there. But we want to get our level up and get the perks so that the stuff we find is actually good. Don't want to be grabbing a, oh, good news, here's your quality 115 sniper rifle. Grats. We also seem to be kind of hungry, apparently. It is very bright here.
Stubborn disconnected.
Okay, so we should make another bow. And we seem to have a visitor someplace around here. Someplace around here, I apparently mean right there. Spikes fixed. We need to plant a new set of trees. We have a bunch of seeds somewhere out here. We have a few seeds we might be able to make use of, but you know, it's not that much. Note, that is totally a lie. We have a shit ton of seeds. We have plenty of meat, not many eggs. We can still get corn and such. So we'll go with this for now, I guess. I think I was melting down some stuff in the forge to get. We should just go ahead and stock up. And we do have a bunch of empty bottles. Perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect. Let's not make quite that many. Let's just go. Our wellness and stuff up. So while we're at it, we'll go ahead and fill up all of these jars too. Dug out, yeah, a large section of the road over there. I was thinking we must have done that at some point. And indeed we have. I'm also planning on slightly longer term, making sure we replace the... Basically I want to A, put down another concrete block to serve as the ground, so it doesn't get deformed by cops exploding or whatever you have, what have you. then I also want to be setting it up so that the innermost ring is I don't know why I just put that there, misclick. That the innermost ring is composed of iron reinforced spikes. Why? Because those last a lot longer and deal much more damage overall for whatever does manage to survive long enough to get there. I have to make sure we have these all back together, and this looks like it's really dead, so let's replace that. That's good enough for now, I think. Do any of you see any particularly empty spots? Seems good enough. Alright, this is now a zombie-free zone, okay? I really don't care about that, won't even take up the inventory space. Digging this up because I'm planning on trying to plant the trees along this very existing stretch of land, probably. And I seem to recall, though I may be completely off the mark here because I didn't actually check and it's been a while, that we had, you know, shit tons of stone, but actually may have been running short on sand. Now, we could make the cement mixer and use that to translate stone into sand, but that comes with another problem. We would actually need a wrench to dismantle cars, and then actually get an engine from the cars, which is not an impossible task by any stretch of the imagination, but it's a fair amount of time and energy right now that I prefer not to be spending on that right now. And, of course, is RNG. We might get a wrench very quickly, and we might get an engine very quickly, and it might be a decent engine. Or we could take, you know, ages to find a wrench, and then ages to find an engine, and I guess the engine quality probably doesn't matter for the mixer, as far as I know, but here we get the guaranteed sand. And we're clearing this path for our lovely trees, so win-win, sort of. Perhaps more pertinently, it actually, I mean, it's compared to breaking stones giving us less mining tool experience, but it still is mining tool experience. That's worth something, at least. We also need to be getting a bunch of steel ready. We're going to want to reinforce the fort with steel every single spot. We'll also throw on some more iron bars to make it even nicer, and then I'm not quite sure when, so I'd rather at least fight off the week 14, possibly even 21 horde without really expanding the base. There's some tips and tricks that I've picked up that I may start sort of going more into there. Like, I've been fiddling with something I've learned / seen and trying to make sure I do it correctly still, that's relatively new to me even, about a way so that you can actually be looting zombies outside, like, as they're dying and during the night. But I don't want to do that quite yet, and it is exposing yourself to a bit more risk. You basically build it so that you have two ramp blocks that have a gap between them that you can, like, see out of downward at an angle, and you loot from that. But the catch is, of course, is to need the zombies to die right outside the gap, and the existence of that gap means, like, a cop explosion now will hit you. So that wouldn't be so great if, you're like, hey, I'm chilling out, I'm being awesome, and this cop's dying outside, he's going to explode. Well, thankfully I'm behind these concrete walls, and I just kind of died because the explosion can hit me. Since I don't have an actual wall of protection, that same gap that allows me to loot them causes the cops to kill me with their explosions. I don't think they can actually spit through it, though, and you shooting through it means you can basically only shoot it. I think they're maybe their legs, maybe their chest, but I'm not even sure of that. I forget. Alright, let's get to planting. Forget Johnny Appleseed. I'm apparently like Balkoth Maple Seed or something. So you might notice trees have to be planted a fair distance from other trees, like multiple voxels. And of course the eternal whine about need to gather more plant fibers and trying to do so in a way that's not completely painful. Yeah, this is kind of dull. Flip side, it'll pay off in a few days, and hopefully we don't have to do it too much overall. We're not exactly in a heavily forested region, though, so... There's trees, yeah, but it's not a tree every, you know, 5 meters. Especially not after we've been cutting a lot of them down, so... We're just doing our part to save the planet, right? Placing down 100 freaking maple seeds here. And no, that was not an exaggeration. Rewind the video if you don't believe me. We did indeed start with 100 maple seeds. We're down to 18. I'm trying to make sure we put them in the gaps and don't accidentally plant them on top of plant fibers, which you can do. And it makes this horrible tree falling sound, and you're like, oh boy, am I going to be killed and crushed by... Oh nice, this entire section's over. Open. Am I going to be killed and crushed by this seedling I put down somehow? Like, I don't even know how that eventually kills me, but...
Yep, I'm the entered channel.
I need more fibers. Recall digging a decent chunk of clay, but I don't remember exactly how much. Probably more wouldn't hurt. It's taking, you know, we need it for the steel anyway, long-term usage and all that, you know? Do we need a bunch of it right this second? No. Long-term? Yeah. You joining the channel, Mike?
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, are you wanting to do something?
Well, not necessarily. If you're busy, I don't mind. I don't know how long I'll be able to game.
I'm just recording a video right now, so I can stop this and do something else for now if you'd like. If you're free, up to you.
I think I'm just gonna work on my solo game for a little bit. Maybe later tonight I'll be available.
Sure, just give me a shout.
Hey, did you play Friday night with Bobby and David and Dez?
No, didn't wind up working out. Next time.
Oh, that's too bad.
Big your 3,000 clay here should be plenty of overkill. What is our mining tool skill in this game? Wow, we're only at 73, okay. Yikes. Play. Hey, more feathers. Probably 3 feathers. Not bad. Not bad at all. This is the kind of awful part, right? Even after all of this right here, are we even up to 350 now? Because we were at 323, and now we're at 343. It takes a long time to gather plant fibers. And we can gather, like, every other resource so much faster. I suppose I should also finish shoveling this entirely, the gravel here. We're trying to clear the area of plant fibers so we have better line of sight on everything. We don't get distracted by crawlers. I'm not saying I want to turn the entire world into a concrete pavement, but... Now, if you're wondering, so why are you still obsessed about the tools? Don't you have pretty good tools? Yeah, but don't quote me on the exact numbers offhand, but you need something like purple tools, low 500s I think works, with 5 out of 5 minor 69ers, and I think you actually need up to like 81, 83-ish, something around that range, in mining tools, in order to start one-shotting the 500 stone blocks with the steel pickaxe. I do know that if you get full tick 600 tool quality, and I think it's at like high 90s in mining tools skill, you can actually one-shot them without miner 69er 5 out of 5. But kind of very much feels like you might as well be able to one-shot them that much sooner, you know? A lot of time that you could be one-shotting them that you aren't, which means that you're it's slower to raise the mining tool skills, and you're not going to be really that short on skill points later on to get the perks and things that we want. It's mainly going to be the levels that we always want more of for better and loot, and guaranteed higher loot, and not getting awful, really bad. As defined, in this case, by quality specifically. I'm not even talking about the type of item, you know. Yeah, we're going to be in a situation where, like, a 600 pistol, who really cares? It's a pistol. But, I'd still rather get a 600 pistol than a 150 pistol. Have we broken 1,000 yet? Nope. We're not even remotely close to 1,000, in fact. How about that? But this does need to be done ultimately. Either way, we want to clear all of this off as we're planning on expanding a little bit of the concrete floor out. We need to put in the intended, we should clear these rocks too, I think, so they don't get, the zombies don't get hung up on them or whatever. Reflecting on the videos and rewatching part of them, I'm definitely not all that thrilled with how the start went here. Yeah, obviously on this difficulty with the default settings and the skill slash experience slash however you wanted to define it that I have, it's not an issue at all. But I don't want to be the guy saying, it works for me, therefore you should be able to do it too. It's like, if it's not the better way to be playing, then I don't want to be encouraging it. So maybe we'll do some experiments for science as part of these videos, especially at points where I feel like I want to sort of slow down again. I sort of have some general goals in mind, really, for a week, if you will. 2% and 6 goldenrod. Probably plant those goldenrod. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And now we fill a bunch of glass jars. Notice how I am making sure I am keeping the first aid and the bow on my bar. I do not want to be risking that. Yes, this is sort of a glitch where if you swap too quickly it doesn't appear, but look, if we swap back, they're there! Magic! Woohoo! And make sure you don't right-click too many times, or you will, yes, indeed, drink the murky water, which I don't think you really want to be doing, but if that's really what you're into, then I won't try to stop you, I guess. Just enjoy the dysentery. Which, mind you, can be cleared up just fine by goldenrod, but still. It is bright here, though, I think. I'm going to need to redo some of the lighting, frankly. So my eyes aren't bleeding from it. Bleeding eyes are bad. I'll go ahead and just leave that on for a bit. We've let the area cool down. I don't think we're going to get a screamer in the immediate future. Looks like we do have a few thousand clay available. Works for me. This will last us for a very, very long time. And we can throw some sand into here. Throw more stone over here. Actually, we will need that. The stone chapels we'll be making. Cotton, actually, we can place in here as well. The egg. Maybe we should put in the food. Should make a hoe and get a sort of farm. I mean, goldenrod's just not really an urgent farm. It's like, you can get plenty of them in this area. It's not like we're transporting them a massive distance, or it's a rare item. I need AFK for a brief second. So, what do we want to bother trying to get finished today at this point? It's suppose, among other things, we can collect more lumber. How are we doing on perks, anyway? We have that, good, two out of that, good, good, good. We'll go ahead and take this. Skin animals faster. We don't need the workbench. Let's take leather tanning. We should be raising gunsmithing. I don't know. Are we actually through processing all of the gunpowder stuff? I know we gathered a whole bunch of it. And again, I will note, by the way, if you're having trouble jumping that gap, looks like we did process it. That it is entirely feasible to, and what I did have this earlier, and then I realized sort of, oh, hey, it's Horde Night, we should probably make some adjustments. So having more like this. Hey, now look, we have a 2 that we can use to make a running start. I may fiddle with some other variants in that design to show how people can accommodate if they have, let's say, if they are jump challenged. Being jump challenged is a terrible thing. And I specifically mention that because I know people who I play with, including some of those people that Mike was talking about a moment ago, who have the darndest time in trying to get across gaps like that. And it's for the sake of those people, in fact, that I wound up experimenting with some other options to try to make it so that the zombies couldn't cross the gap, but they weren't falling and dying to the spikes to the same degree that they have in the past, let's say. I should also make it. I can make a ceiling and a upper floor, and I can make a rooftop farm too. Weirdly enough, for a rooftop farm, what am I wearing? I'm seriously overheating with nothing but a bandana. That is just fantastic. Oh, and if anyone's wondering, the survivor that I have, the model, that's just one of the, I just had random a few times, and then I think I changed his hair color and made him have not quite the insane hair he had prior, but how insane is this guy's hair? Yeah, I think it had, like, super long hair, and I'm like, you know what, let's just shorten that slightly. And then it said, whatever. I think it's like a mustache, almost like Hitler style or something. Should be processing some stuff as we go through this, so how am I not hitting the grass? That's crazy. Not sure I even want to know it. Tailoring skill level 5, damn. Not sure I want to know how bad it is here. Skill 153. Oh, damn. Bow before our tailoring skill. Bow before it. The But I see miscellaneous crafting was like really, yeah, we really need to get miscellaneous crafting up. That's a good chunk of extra levels. That's a big thing to be worried about. Maybe we'll go ahead and scrap this. How are we going to raise miscellaneous crafting, you might ask? Answer, by making wood log spikes, probably. You can, I think we might have talked about these numbers before, but you can turn 15 stacks of 1,000 wood into one stack of 500 wood log spikes. So it is extremely efficient in terms of saving and being able to craft a bunch of stuff while without taking up your entire inventory to do so. Point where we're doing more than 200 damage per hit with the fire axe, so literally it would take 3 hits instead of 5 in order to replace wood frames with rebar. So maybe that's a more feasible option now if we wanted to say, well, you know what, we're going to build the entire underground section with concrete. See, that's a waste of concrete. Well, yeah, to some degree, but it still gives us construction tool skill. It still gives us, you know, better defenses just in case something a little weird happens. And we're going to have the concrete anyway, like crafting it gives us something to be doing, more miscellaneous crafting too. I don't really have another urgent use right now for it, so... we're kind of in a situation, it's like better to be... how to put it, better to be gathering and spending resources now, even if you don't have to. They give you long-term benefits. But you might be interested in knowing that the guy who requested that I make these videos, I mentioned that the first one was up and he watched it. More up or now, up at this point, but back then it was just the first one that was uploaded. And he was like, wow, you know, you're actually getting a lot of results out of just crafting, like, the tools, and he was afraid of throwing away mats, basically. And he's like, don't think of them as, like, throwing away and wasting mats, think of it as investing them. Yeah, you're tossing away a bunch of plant fibers and wood and stone that you gathered, and probably, perhaps, for that day for sure, and maybe even the next day, you are behind in materials, relative if you're trying to gather them for specific purposes, but after that, you're going to start reaping dividends from your initial investment. Well, dividends isn't really the right term, that's more for stock, so... but... you'll get a return on your investment, at least. As you gather stuff faster and faster. Things that are very limited resources, like I wouldn't be investing brass, for example, usually, or paper, into something you're not going to be using long term. It's not very early on. Possibly later on, but probably not. The only reason I'm saying possibly is because you could, in theory, get to the point where the game is just so easy and you're overflowing in brass and, like, whatever, I can do what I want. But in that circumstance, you know, sure, do whatever you want. We aren't there yet, though. Bad at leveling up tailoring in most games. Partially because I tend not to get hit that much, and I'm used to worrying more about weapons and tools than armor. And the armor smithing skill itself is a completely different skill for heavy armor. However, it turns out that tailoring, you know, you're still going to be using a tailored shirt, tailored legs, and, you know, theoretically a tailored bandana, unless you happen to find a specific quality one. So from that perspective, you know, leveling up tailoring gives you... Because plant fibers seem to offer much better protection than the found clothes. For whatever reason. Less waterproofing, less insulation, but better raw protection from damage. On the flip side, with the new armor system stuff that they've done, I'm not sure if it actually really has an impact outside of once your actual armor is destroyed. I'm trying to figure out exactly how that bit works. We're nearly hitting night, so let's go on and hide. Should have turned this off a long time ago. Well, I was gonna say that, then I'm like, well, I guess I have to take it back, because that actually wouldn't really help, since I forgot that we had this filled up with some other stuff. So, that was a rather large oops. I don't really think I'm too worried about melting more sand in, quite frankly. So let's melt the anvils, and then we'll resume to melting clay. And we'll leave it at that for a bit, since it's going to take a while to process. Clay will be used for everything from bullet tips to bullet casings to future glass jars to steel to iron to rebar frames, right? You know, you name it, it'll be used. These two forges, we can restock both of them. Turn on all the forges. About 30 seconds on that. That's good. The great stone shovel's done. Hey, Screamer, what's up? Oh, we're up to 487 tools. I guess we haven't bothered to make better steel ones yet. Probably because it didn't wind up actually making a practical difference, perhaps. Not sure. Closing in on that 500 quality mark. The anvil crafting and don't get the XP from it. Yes, I said that correctly. Rather, perhaps I should say I said it more accurately than what I would prefer it to be. plenty of concrete mix right now made. Not sure plenty is quite the word I should use, but perhaps a lot. Maybe 2,000. Should probably make more rebar frames, though. Only about 200 because we need to melt a bunch of iron. Right side, there should be lots of miscellaneous crafting skill. Like that right there. Since we have a lot of other ways to be raising miscellaneous crafting skill, like, you know, mixing concrete or making those wood log spikes I was talking about, I am not particularly concerned about losing out on XP here by not having the empty forge open for all of it. And once again, we're making use of both crafting cues right now. Come on, 500 tool quality, here we're there. If you're wondering, 9203 to 91.94. That was currently the last one. I should just queue them all up, whatever. Or in other words, transitioning quality colors does not, like, magically make it jump up by a massive amount. It's, as far as I can tell, it's just a straight progression otherwise. But it's shiny. So we want it by 9 there, right? 0.09. 0.08. So, I mean, I guess there's technically a slightly larger difference there, but, I mean, yeah. 0.09 increase per hit rather than 0.08 increase per hit. And I'm kind of wondering, wishing I had kept some of the other stuff so I could... Oh, hey, how about that? So that is 0.03 to point. That's 0.08. So maybe it's something like for stone shovel. And this differs between every tool as well. That's the other part, right? But you're still talking a 1% increase would be about 0.9, right? And we're talking about 0.09. So we're talking about a 10th of a percent of an increase per quality point or something like that, I believe. Flip side, that means every 10 is 1%, every 100 is 10%. You know, every 300, you're talking about like at least a 30% improvement. And not to mention the talent skill points or whatever. And obviously, if it's worse to start with, if it's adding a flat amount on, then it's even more of an increase earlier on. And once you... 500 plus, the quality improvements matter a lot less, in all fairness. How they would claim otherwise. Once you have minor 69er, 5 out of 5, you don't really need to necessarily get the tool quality up that much more. But, it is still a large chunk of XP if you can manage to swing it. that. That is useful. That if some of you are looking for massive firefights with zombies and stuff, that'll be coming up. And by coming up, I don't mean like, you know, next video. I mean that it'll eventually be there, but right now, I have been more focused on getting the foundations of the base and all the groundwork laid and actually leveling up and getting the perks and everything so that... Hey, the clay's melting again. So that when we do start to be serious about looting everything, we actually are getting good stuff, as I mentioned earlier. I'm debating whether to max scavenging or just take scavenging up to like 90, which I think still is like a probably at least a, I'm guessing like 48 increase rather than 50 increase. So two quality difference with the benefit meaning of the fact that that allows us to get very slowly, but still allows us to get more XP from scavenging leveling up the last bit. I don't know how much above 60 it'll be worth pushing. So I think at 60 you're still getting like plus 35 at least quality. We'll see. Scavenging's a long way. Should pay, what, 54 points, which would leave us at 27 remaining. No, wait, 54 points would leave us at 17 remaining. Which means we need 7 more levels before we can max quality gear, since I bought, like, leather tanning and that kind of stuff. Am I even level, like, 60 yet? No, level 57. I think that miscellaneous crafting, I think, is something I've really been slacking on relative to what I'm usually doing. That is one of the biggest issues. So increase here. I'm not quite 60. We're nearly out. But quite a chunk indeed. Quite a chunk.
Huh?
I'm wondering whether we're actually going to fill the current chests with these clubs, or I think we're going to wind up running short and need to cancel it and make more chests. I was debating doing that earlier, and then I was like, we'll see, I guess. Or maybe I psychically knew. I knew I had another chests there already made. See? That was actually sheer brilliance on my part, and that's what I'm going to call it. Sheer brilliance. Absolutely do not endorse slash support the current XP system where you only get XP for naturally leveling perks. Naturally leveling perks. No XP for zombie kills. I get that they're trying to not potentially have people who are going around killing zombies getting too much XP compared to base builders, but right now it's not just completely reversed, but it creates a situation where, unless you want people to be annoyed at you, especially in a multiplayer game, hey guys, I went and I looted the shotgun Messiah, I brought back some orange quality gun parts, and like, you idiot, why would you go and loot it when you're like level 10 or something on day 2, you know, you just ruined a chance at like purple quality gun parts later on when you actually have a better level in quality gel and such. I don't like the fact that it encourages that. I mean, I have a friend who does like to scavenge and he really hates any kind of base building and he wants to go out and loot, and I'm constantly biting my tongue and basically muttering under my breath to myself, you know, god damn it, he took the supply drop that could have had, like, purple shit in it if I or somebody else had looted who was high level, and instead we got, like, this orange or, if we're lucky, yellow quality shit. Thanks. Because, of course, we're talking about, like, non-renewable resources there. It's not like you can have... Okay, yeah, you get an airdrop every 3 days. It's renewable in that sense. But it's not renewable in the sense that you wouldn't say, man, Tommy went and mined out that, you know, quarry over there and dug a giant pit in the ground to harvest stone. You know, there is no more stone to be found because Tommy took all the stone. No, there's stone everywhere. You can go anywhere you want in the world and dig and bring it back, and you're not hurting anyone, in effect, or depriving them of an opportunity, really, of doing that. Or at least not to any substantial degree. Oh, hey, Dawn. Next video.